This ought to be interesting.
They aren't here to keep us away from Beklon. They're here to keep us from escaping him.
Very well.
I shall deliver the souls of Akkar and J'mpok.
That is more like it. I accept your generous offer. Deliver those souls to me, and Gowron shall be free as well. And now, I give you leave to go. Be gone.
Again, I'm happy to oblige them.
Be mindful of their numbers and their treachery. Open the front gate! Kortar is waiting for us on the farm.
That's not the only thing waiting for us on the other side. Get ready to fight!
There's the barge. Hurry!
Of course, they have fire-breathing tar.
Kortar, prepare to weigh anchor. We are leaving in a hurry. Welcome back to the world of the living. And not a moment too soon. A few minutes ago, sensors detected energy signatures overboard. Fekiri portals. They're sending vessels through as we speak. Has her soul been liberated? Was your mission a success?
She was right beside us, fighting the whole way. Did she make it to the barge?
She did. I made sure of it. Check her vitals. Give me a medical update now!
Her life signs are strong. Reading brain activity. Yes! You did it! Lorel has returned safe and sound. Kapla! Right. Three portals in total. Fekiri vessels are emerging from them as we speak. They're holding position for now, but we are heavily outnumbered.
Lorel's presence may be a coincidence. Since their return to our space, the Fakiri have made numerous assaults on Barret. Until now, those attacks were repelled by the KDF. And now, with the Empire in a state of disarray, the defense presence here is minimal. The Fakiri saw a weakness, and they seized the initiative. This time, they may succeed where they have failed so many times before. Indeed, if the Fakiri want to fight, they came to the right place. I will fight to the end if I must, for today is a good day to die.
Well said, Lord. I stand ready for battle as you risked all to restore me to life. Honor demands that I fight alongside you, and I do so gladly.
So be it. We will make our stand here. Let it be known that we never forgot what it means to be Klingon! I will need to go with one of you, however. After the loss of the Lucara, I have no vessel to command in battle.
I believe I can be of assistance there, Lady J'Ula. The monks of Boreth are not entirely without ears, but we will need some time to prepare. Do what you can to hold the line. Until then, Lady J'Ula, Mother, please come with me.
Fakiri portal count remains at 3. Reading multiple enemy vessels in the system, we're outnumbered at least 3-1.
Our first priority should be closing those portals. Until they're gone, our Fakiri problem could continue to grow.
I'm reading heavy fluctuations in their graviton fields. At the moment, they appear to be unstable, but they could stabilize over time. Until then, it is a weakness.
Weapons fire, especially torpedoes, will eventually destabilize a portal's integrity to the point of collapse.
We need to punch through the ships guarding the portals before reinforcements arrive.
It won't take much to collapse the portals.
Take them out as soon as you can.
Coming in from the last corner. finish that sentence. We are Klingons. We will fight to the end.
Yes! Boreth shall not fall today. Ship is
fight ready. Now! For Kaelis! Boreth! For the Empire!
This is the ISS Continuum, calling all Klingon forces. I am Lorel of House Dekuma. Join me! Fight now! For the Empire! Kapla!
Thank you.
victory is ours! Together, we have protected Forreth from our enemies, and returned she who was called Mother to the Empire!
Truly a glorious battle, my lady. The Fakiri will think twice before launching an attack here anytime soon.
Even so, things got too close for my liking. For a time, it seemed like there were more Fakiri in space than stars. Thankfully, the monks had that well-preserved surprise up their sleeves. Just where did you find that relic, Tanavik?
We have kept it here since my mother's time. Once it served as her flagship, we preserved it as a reminder of a Klingon golden age. We knew one day it would be needed again, and it seems that time has come at last.
Indeed. Though I yearn to command the Katinga once more, it has been far too long since I have done so. Space warfare has changed considerably since my time. Until I have reacclimated myself to this era, I can think of no better warrior to command this vessel than Lady J'Ula of House Mokai. May you lead this vessel and its crew to glory.
You honor me, Lorel. Computer, note the transfer of command in the record of battle. For many, the Lucara was a symbol of division. May the Katinga serve as a symbol of unity, as my brother's vessel once did. Let the honored few who came to Boreth's aid go now to every corner of the Empire. Tell everyone you meet what happened here today. Tell them that you were at Boreth when Lorel returned. Tell them how we all fought and sent the Fakiri back to Grethar. There is much to be done. We have an empire to restore, and a tyrant to depose. But now is not the time for such things. Now is the time to honor our great victories. Tonight, we celebrate, for tomorrow we may die. Kapla!
Now that Lorel has been restored, she will be able to counsel Lady J'Ula on a great many things. Though I have great respect for J'Ula, there are always lessons to be learned as a leader in the Klingon Empire. And, in such matters, there is no better teacher than Lorel. Yes, with Lorel at her side, I believe Lady J'Ula can lead our house to victory over J'mpok and restore our shattered empire to glory. That battle lies ahead of us, however. When the time comes, be ready to answer the call to arms.
Congratulations, Captain.